Hi there. Well, it's about time we jump into more puddles and take a look at another Fisher-Price Read and Play Puddle Book. This is the second installment in the Fisher-Price Read and Play Puddle Book Library, and here is Fisher-Price Read and Play Yolanda Yellsalot, made in 1996, developed by Funnybone Interactive and published by Davidson and Associates. Yolanda spends a day with her mother out in the town, but it seems that when Yolanda speaks, all she ever does is yell. Help Yolanda discover that it's what you say, not just how loud you say it. Yep. On the cover art, notice how Yolanda's clothes are a different color. In the actual game, the clothes are not represented their color as the cover art. So yeah, that's basically it. So let's pop this in the old Hewlett Packard Pavilion and it's puddle time. Now this time I'm going to use this 640 by 480 256 color display which is the recommended settings. Normally I would use 600 by 800 display with a 24-bit true color display, but I'm gonna go with this one from now on. So let's go. Let's yell a lot.
You can type in a new name or click anywhere on the screen to continue.
So normally you have the anamorphic rabbit,
Richardson J. Rabbit,
the anamorphic wolf, Grandmother.
Hello there, children. I'm Grandmother.
And the Puddle Book mascot, PJ Puddle.
Hi, I'm PJ Puddles.
Anyways, let's go. In Gamers Comms play for Yolanda Yellsalot, you see him have Grandmother Casey narrate the story, but here we're gonna play with PJ Puddle's narration. So yeah, are you ready? Here we go.
Yolanda Yellsalot. There once was a girl named Yolanda Yellsalot, whose voice always put her in a sticky spot. Whenever she would speak or talk or tell, she would simply always, always yell. When introducing herself, she'd say, I'm Yolanda Yellsalot. How are you today?
And here we're greeted by Sandy Speaks So Soft, the fairy.
I'm Sandy Speaks So Soft. I'll join you on each page. You'll find me in the beginning and at the end on stage.
Yeah, Sandy. Let's go.
There once was a girl named Yolanda Yellsalot, whose voice always put her in a very sticky spot. Whenever she would speak or talk or tell, she would simply always yell. For instance, if she were to introduce herself, she'd say,
what would you like to do when you get older?
I want to be a
is your name?
My name's Yolanda Yellsalot, silly! Haven't you been paying attention?
Yeah, every time you play this page again, the questions will be different. Like,
do you have a favorite number?
Yep, I sure do! My favorite number is 5! Because that's how many times I can jump on one foot! Do you want to see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7! I have 7 times! So now my favorite number is 7!
Yep, basically, Yolanda sure does yells a lot! Yep. By the way, every time you replay this page, that question may be different. It will be a different question, one of them.
Yolanda loved to yell. She loved to holler so much. She went up to the library to learn to yell in Dutch. She asked the librarian, "Can you help me find a book? I'm new to this library, and I don't know where to look." The librarian and all of the people said, "Shh, shush, hush, quiet please," Yolanda muttered as she left. "I just wanted a book. Why are you shush-hushing me?"
You need to whisper in a library. Keep very quiet. People here are looking for information, so don't cause a riot.
Anyways, look! There's the lie! Bully Lovefield and his heroic wet dog, and I think that's Stacy Fazuli. Yeah, there's a number of lie references in this also cult classic. Yolanda runs into the library and yells at the librarian.
"Can you help me find a book? I'm new to this library, and I don't know where to look!"
"Shush! Quiet, please!"
Yolanda breaks the rules and everything falls off the shelves. And even some of the characters fall from their pictures. Everything.
Oh my God.
Yolanda broke the rules and turned the library into a mess.
You will have to
even the lie fell out of his picture.
Oops! Hey! Could you help me clean up this area? I'll start over here!
Don't worry, Yolanda. I will not. We put the lie back in place. There's the lie. Yeah, basically, Yolanda is an idiot. And we have now, he's ruined the entire library. Now I have to fix it. Put it, clean everything up.
Don't forget the children's room!
Thank you. much all of it.
Wow, terrific! Thanks for your help!
And Yolanda broke the rules again, and more books fall from the shelves, which I just cleaned up. Everything falls from the shelf again, except for the lie and those mice in the shelves in that picture.
When Yolanda and her mom dined out, even at the restaurant, she continued to shout, "Hey, Mom! I don't know what that man is eating over there, but it looks a lot like a big plate of red, greasy hair!" The manager demanded they leave as soon as they were able. Yolanda said, "That's fine with me! I'd rather eat in a stable!"
Saying gross things while people are eating is really kind of rude. It ruins people's appetites so they can't eat their food.
Wearing a Puddle Book sweater. Oh boy, I want to like one.
Down or leave the restaurant.
That's enough now. What would you like to eat, Yolanda?
I don't know. Why don't you pick out something for me? Just click on the menu to see what you can order.
Roy, I don't know what I want, but I definitely do not want one of those plates of red, greasy hair.
Or maybe perhaps a purple, greasy birther. Can't believe I made a leapfrog.
Oh, I think I'm fading away! Oh, I'm starving!
And while some areas are clickable, Yolanda will keep pestering you until you click the menu.
Shh, did you hear that?
I'm guessing that's red greasy hair, the spaghetti and thing. Yeah, I'm guessing that's red greasy
Click
hair.
Click on the menu items to see what they are. When you are satisfied with your choice, click on me and I will put your order in.
Okay, let's see. How about morning munchies, huh? Pancakes!
Mega. Shrimp. Liver.
Liver.
French fries.
Bow-tied French fries!
Chocolate cake, sweet and sour, whipped cream.
Yeah, by the way, the restaurant they're dining out is called the Picky Eden Diner. Yeah, that's that's
iced tea.
I haven't had stuff like this since the Krusty Krab and the crab. You know what? I guess this will do. Every time you replay this page, the menus, the items on the menu will be different.
I would like, I'll have the kebab and some fries, please. Thank you.
You mean the spaghetti and meatballs he's eating? The I think that's it here. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it here.
They went to a store with clothes so exquisite. But to that store they only made one visit. She suggested to her mom what each customer should wear. And her suggestions received only grave or grim glares. Her neighbor, Mrs. Lofton Bearbow, gave Yolanda a look that she couldn't quite figure. When Yolanda said to her mom, "Hey, she could use a few sizes bigger!"
People are usually sensitive about how others see them. You know, their looks. Things you probably shouldn't say could fill 1,000 books.
Get ready for another catchy song sequence, and there is a live reference in here. Let's go!
Hi, can I help you? Oh, I see. You would prefer to help yourself.
On into our funky boutique. We've got styles to make you unique. Colors gone wild, guaranteed to smile. Dress up, Yolanda. Switch it up and mix and match.
Like a baby doll, not a cabbage patch.
The racks are packed from end to end. Bring in your mother and tell your best friend.
Try it on full size, Yolanda. Try it on full size. Try it on full size, Yolanda.
Something smart and sassy, bold and brassy and refined and classy. You've never seen clothes this contagious. Magazine pages can't contain
it. From the clean and tweaky to the furry and the freaky.
From the grim and proper to the cheeky and the geeky. Let the cut change with your mood. Dress up, Yolanda. Express your attitude.
Try it on full size, Yolanda. Try it on full size. Try it on full size, Yolanda.
Dress up, dress up.
Snickers, two for $5.
Try it on full size, Yolanda. Try it on full size.
Go ahead, try it on, Yolanda.
She could use a few sizes bigger.
Oh my! Oh, Yolanda.
Try all of them. Everyone.
That's nice, I guess. You don't like this one, do you? Oh, I love this one. The hat is really cool.
You're gonna.
Especially the birds.
You're gonna like the next one, and is that Susie?
My friend Susie has a pink
Nope.
Don't you think the ruffles are just great?
Mm-mm.
Very regal. This is definitely me. I look like a queen. I don't think so. You don't like this one, do you?
Out of all the outfits I prefer, my favorite have to be this one.
My friend Susie has a pink dress just like this.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah. It's perfect. Let's get out of here.
Mom, can I get this one? Please, 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 please. I really like it.
Sure, I think it looks cute on you. I'll go pay for it.
Thank you, Mom!
You're welcome, Yolanda.
Yeah, I like this one. Now Yolanda is like Susie the redhead.
Look, she whispered to her mom at the mall. It really was not a whisper at all. That man over there has enormous ears. Everyone turned with ogles and goggles and looks and leers. Whoop, said Yolanda. Did I say that too loud?
Yes, bellowed the big-eared man from the crowd.
Differences are fun, not better or worse at all. Did you see all the wonderfully different people on the escalator at the mall?
May those be Funnybone Interactive cameos? Yep. You will see Funnybone Interactive characters coming down the escalator.
Okay. I know I smell.
That's from Stay Tuned, but I forgot what his name is. There's Pete. There's Richardson the Rabbit. Before we go on and do stuff, let's take the time to look at Funnybone characters come down the escalator. There's Grandmother Casey. I don't know. I don't remember him. There's that squirrel from Baxter's birthday. I forgot what his name was. There's Baxter the Bear Cub, also from Baxter's birthday. There's Mrs. Fazuli. Oh my god, it's the lie! That be PJ Puddles, the Puddle Book mascot? The characters I know are Pix, Elk, Chisel, Fiddle, and Skits from Scoops from Stay Tuned. There's the cow from After the Beanstalk.
Hey, Louie, wait
up! There's Susie! He doesn't even realize Yolanda's wearing the same outfit as she is! There's Mrs. Lumpfield. That one's from Louie Lumpfield, also. Oh, there's PJ Puddles! Look, it's a lie!
My friend Susie knows that one!
Yep, I'm... The legendary lie! Always turn your weekends upside down. that lie again. Imagine if the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers were around to beat the lie down. That was twisted. Not once. Oh, that was for Baxter's birthday, but I forgot what her name was. Clones are. Oh my god. Clones are coming down the escalator!
Oh! I love dolphins!
I don't know who that red square. Oh, there's Chisel from Stay Tuned! There's a dark-skinned Louis Lumfield with a bright red shirt.
Oh, I have to remember to get steak and cabbage.
There's the zookeeper from The Lie.
I love throwing pennies into fountains and making wishes. Would you like to try? I've got some pennies right here for you.
The lie will always be watching you. I know if it's from Baxter's birthday, but always forgot what his name was. Yeah, you can throw them around, but it's hard to do it. Stay Tuned.
Wow, look at all the stores!
I know that's from Louis Lumfield, but I forgot what his name was. Well, don't have time to mess around. Let's keep going.
Yolanda's mom just couldn't take any more. Yolanda had been banned from every restaurant and store. Then Yolanda's mom thought, I have the solution to it all. I'll take her to a park where she can play ball. She couldn't possibly disrupt in a place with all that outside noise. Yolanda grabbed her baseball mitt and played ball with some girls and boys.
Well, can't jump in this page, so let's move on.
This plan was going well, playing loud, happy games in the park. All Yolanda's mom heard was lots of kids yelling and an occasional bark. Yolanda's team was up at bat. Yolanda watched from the bench. A player hit a pop fly. Suddenly, Mom felt her hands clench. And then it came, as certain as rain falls and as sure as crazy glue sticks. My cat hits better than that. And what? Are your pants full of bricks?
What Yolanda yelled seemed a bit mean in a game played for fun. Maybe she could have said, good try, Louie. Next time, you'll hit that ball to the sun.
Louie Lumfield sounds different here, unlike in his Puddle Book. It didn't get released till 1998.
Aw, shucks. Oh, well.
There's Melanie and Tommy Jacob. Basically have to time the hat had to hit the ball that comes when at the right time. If you use the mitt, you have to catch
what
Yolanda hits the ball to you. You know, I'm gonna go with the bat because I think that's the best way to do it.
Just click on me when you think I should swing.
Self-explanatory.
Ah, Yolanda's mom said, I think I know how to bring this yelling to an end. Yolanda's mom had remembered Randy, her colorful, wonderful friend. They went to the theater to see a show that Randy was performing. Yolanda leaned towards her mom and said,
This is almost as fun as standing among bees that are swarming. Come on, Mom,
Yolanda said.
This is boring. Let's go.
No, replied Yolanda's mom. We're meeting my friend Randy after the show.
Lots of people pay money to see a great show. If you intend to talk during a performance, you just shouldn't go.
Thank you! I am wounded.
That is it. You may clap now. Thank you! Thank you!
Shh. I'm guessing it's pretty much it. Let's keep going.
Yolanda's mom took her backstage to meet the actors from the play. They got just close enough to hear the man who played the lead say,
"Did you hear that girl in the crowd? So loud and impolite? Her behavior was unkind and uncaring. It really just wasn't right. Why, just last week, my friend Frank was crushed and in tears when some young girl loudly made fun of his ears."
Cannot jump into this page.
"And Mrs. Lofton Barabow hasn't left her house for a week. She's so morose after a mean little girl made her feel big, ugly, and gross. Poor Mrs. L, she's so special, so kind, and so dear. Words can hurt people badly. That fact is abundantly clear. Some people don't realize how quickly sadness and hurt are created. It takes only some words that are mean or too loudly stated."
Cannot jump into this page either.
Yolanda began to cry, softly, not loudly at all. "Mom, I've been so bad," as her tears continued to fall. "I forgot that the people I talk about are just like me, they're real. Now that I heard that man talking, I guess I know how they feel. I feel sad and unliked. I think my heart just started to crack. I should have thought before speaking. I wish I could take it all back."
Gosh, I don't think Yolanda would have yelled all those things if she had just thought for a minute. She hurt people's feelings. She sure got herself stickly stuck in it.
By the way, the Puddle Book demos always seem to pick this page. Why couldn't it have been page 2 at the library? Why'd they have to pick the most depressing page for the demos?
"Poor Mrs. L. She's so kind and so dear. Words can hurt people badly. That fact is abundantly clear. Some people don't realize how quickly sadness and hurt are created. It takes only some words that are mean or too loudly stated."
"I've been so bad. I forgot that the people I talk about are just like me. They're real. Now that I heard that man talking, I guess I know how they feel. I feel sad and unliked. I think my heart just started to crack. I should have thought before speaking. I wish I could take it all back."
And Yolanda cries because she's realized that she's made a terrible mistake.
"I'm very sad. Here, will you dry my tears?"
And now we have to use the force to dry Yolanda's tears.
"Thank you. I'm still a little sad, though. I think there's something hidden around here that will cheer me up." Could you find it and give it to me, please?
Now we have to use the force again to carry the pink bear to Yolanda. And we used the force to bring puppets from the audience.
"Terrific puppets! I love puppets! They're cool!" "Hello there! Are you
the little thing?" "Oh, yes, and I'm looking for some silly shoes to go with my silly hat. Could you tell me where to find them?"
"Yes, yes! I was just going there! Follow me!"
Whee!
birds usually make me smile.
Of paint.
You know what? I don't feel like using the crayons. I want to use the buckets of paint.
Click on a picture you'd like to color.
I don't have time
light
for...
Light blue. Purple.
I'm not going to mess with this. I'm just going to... Did I just recreate... Shantae?
Red.
Did I just recreate Shantae?
Orange.
Like way forward technologies, Shantae. Oh my god, I just...
Yellow.
Look, I actually made something like Shantae. Ah. Yeah, I don't have time for...
Click on a picture you'd like.
These are all the pictures you can color in.
Yellow. Purple.
I just made Shantae again. No, really? I'm actually recreating Shantae, the half genie euro.
Purple.
Now I've just made Miss Yolanda Shantae as well.
Orange.
Shantae yells a lot. Yolanda yells more like Shantae yells a lot. You know what? This is stupid. I want to keep going.
Man turned around and yelled, quite to Yolanda's surprise, "Hello, Yolanda! I'm Randy!" he shouted with a sparkle in his eyes. "I have a secret for you," Randy said, and looked at Yolanda's mom with a smile. Then Randy said, "I knew you were there all the while. Yolanda, a long time ago, I was taught the same lesson that you have just learned. I think that you understand what I mean now that the table has turned."
Cannot jump in this page.
"There are some things you should say only to yourself, and certainly not in a yell," Yolanda replied. "I guess I see now, but gee, I really yell well." Then Randy said softly, "Yolanda, I'll make you a deal that will help to set things right. We can make some time for you to yell with all your yelling might. The rest of the time, remember this rule. Then rough times you'll get through. Say only things about people that you would want them to say about you."
Some words need to be whispered, some yelled, and some not said. Sometimes it is hard to keep which should be what all straight in your head.
Now here's where we get to the yellometer.
"Hello, this is my yellometer. A yellometer is very special. It lets you pick words and choose how quietly or loudly I should say them. Here's how you play. Pick a word from the window below. You can scroll through the list of words by clicking on the arrow buttons. Pick a word, then click on how you think I should lay it.
Basically, you can make Yolanda say, for instance, either yell, talk, or whisper.
"Hey, you! Hey, you!
Hey, you!
I like ice cream! I like ice cream!
I like ice cream!
Hi! Hi!
Hi!
I don't feel like going for all of them.
Look out!
take.
Scuba diving! Scuba diving!
Scuba diving.
Is that a bug?
Is that a bug? Is that a bug?
What smells?
What smells? What smells?
Trick or treat!
Trick or treat! Trick or treat!
Mustard!
Mustard! Mustard!
Jelly beans!
Jelly beans! Jelly beans!
Excuse me!
Excuse me! Excuse me!
Well done, Yolanda. You just broke your own joke. I mean, you just broke your own rule.
Quiet, please.
I really don't want to go through all of them.
Pumpkins!
Pumpernickel and pumpkins. Pumpernickel and pumpkins.
Splat!
I guess this is the last one I'll do.
Splat.
Did you see that frog, Lemon?
Frog!
Frog! Frog!
Look out! Look out! Leap the frogs armed and dangerous with a slime cannon! Oh, can't believe we made another leapfrog reference.
Wiggling wildebeests!
Wiggling wildebeests!
Wiggling wildebeests. Do you have any gum?
No, I don't have any gum.
Do you have any gum?
No.
Do you have any gum?
No, no! I tried to be like...
Dexter D. Wonder Dog!
Dexter D. Wonder Dog.
Who came up with a name like Dexter D. Wonder Dog?
Dexter D. Wonder
Dog. Is he supposed to be like a character from Stay Tuned that never made it to... That never made it into Stay Tuned?
Shh! The baby's sleeping!
I just broke your own rule again, Yolanda. You just broke your own rule again.
I stormed in like an elephant! Bran is overrated! I love this movie!
I love this! Computer thing.
Let's go on the roller coaster.
Goodbye.
Yolanda worked hard to learn when to speak kindly or say things to herself or keep mum. She learned she was different from others and differences are fine and are fun. Randy kept his promise to Yolanda. Tuesdays they take center stage. Then they go into their shouting, hollering, fun-yelling rage. Together you'll hear them whooping it up on Tuesdays at 4. This is what you will hear if you dare walk through the door.
Cannot jump in this page, so now, finally for the finale.
Where Yolanda yells a lot, and Randy really loud. We're actors on a stage, a place where it's okay for us to yell in a crowd. Yolanda, let's sing a song about pastry, as loud as we can shout. No, Randy, let's yell. I tried to wash the dog, but he's stuck in the water spout. Together they will yell on and on without sense or purpose or rhyme. And if you ask them why, they'll tell you because here and now is the appropriate time. Boy, Yolanda sure yells a lot. If you would like me to read the story to you again, just click on the picture of Yolanda.
But it's one last thing to do.
Hello! Now it's time for Yolanda and me to perform our silly yelling fun. You can be the director and tell us what to do.
This is the song box! Click on the arrows to go backwards and forwards through the song list!
Click on the...
You know what? You can do it and flip. Side to side, Russian disco and bump. You may go for all the songs, but I don't feel like changing the dance steps. Maybe Susie's, you might ask.
Yolanda is my name, and yelling is my game, but only on the stage can I act out in a rage! Me and my friend Randy, together we are dandy. We love to yell, alright? Every Tuesday night!
Story of Yolanda yells a lot and Randy really loud.
Thank you.
song that needs a remix in the style of Jake Kaufman. And Yolanda hits the baseball and it breaks her computer screen. Developed by Funnybone Interactive. Copyright 1996, Funnybone Interactive. There's a lie hiding in that prison. He scored a draw to Davidson. Oh, no. I would like to thank you all for watching me and the story of Yolanda Yellsalot. Join me next time for After the Beanstalk. Bye-bye.
Golly galoshes, do you really have to go? Okay, hope you had a splash.
See you next time.